What's up guys and welcome to today's video. In today's video I'm going to give you guys 10 tips on how to become a better builder in Fortnite Creative. Alright guys, so before we start today's video I just want to say thank you guys so much for 10,000 subscribers. This is such a huge milestone for any YouTube creator out there and I'm really really grateful for it. When I started this YouTube channel 2 months ago I had absolutely no idea if I would ever reach this, but I'm so happy I jumped out and tried to make YouTube tutorials, tips and tricks and even speed goals. And people have been asking me what to do for 10,000 subscribers and I really don't know, but I've seen quite some people talking about a Q&A, so if you guys have any questions to me, leave them in the comments down below. And if that's enough, I might make a video on it. If that's not, we'll just make another tutorial next time. And yeah, let's just get into the video. So the first tip I got for you guys is the cone trick. This is a trick a lot of creators across the community uses a lot. Basically, if you multi-select a prop with a cone or any other playable structure, you can move this prop in exact tiles and rotate it exactly 90 degrees. The second tip is emojis on signs. You guys might not know this, but you can actually use emojis on signs. Basically what I do is that I look up the emoji page called getemoji.com. So for instance, you guys can pick the key emoji and put it on a billboard and there you go, now you have a key in your map. The third tip is to place your map a couple floors up. This is because you always want to have some space under your map where your mechanics can go. Maybe you later in the process of building your map want an underground area. You can't do that if you're building on the bottom level, so always bring your builds a couple levels up. You might need that extra space. The fourth tip is to always use new assets. I know if you guys need the haunted props and you need some of the old haunted stuff, you guys can use that. But I'm mostly talking when we get updated stuff like terrain, trees, rocks. Go and use some of that. Don't be stuck using the old chapter 1 trees. Update your trees to the new more higher quality trees. The fifth tip is to build and test your maps with your friends. If you're building maps for yourself, there's a whole community out there to explore. There's creators of all sizes looking for more to collaborate with. And you can find these people in the official creator Discord or in my Discord for instance. I just made a completely fresh Discord specifically for Fortnite Creative and this channel as well. So definitely hop in there, maybe there might be some looking for another partner. Number 6. Use reference images. In a lot of cases, it's really good to get inspiration. I'm not telling you to go and copy building straight into your map, but sometimes having reference images of what a given theme looks like is a really, really good idea. It doesn't matter if you're a new creator or market makes, everyone's using reference images at this point. So go and use them, get inspired, and create some awesome stuff. The seventh tip is a little bit more advanced. It's the circles trick. This is really, really important. And basically you can build circles out of any size, of any shape. I made a complete video on this trick and I'm gonna make a card up here where you guys can click to get into that video. I really, really encourage you guys to click it either after this video or now. It's gonna help you guys a ton. The eighth tip is really, really simple. Basically, bag up frequently. You can bag up in two ways. You can make a bag up within the same island, but you can also duplicate your island to a new version. This is something I do a lot and it can usually get a little bit messy, so make sure you clean up in it afterwards. But just in general, make backups. It's really, really important. And you definitely don't want to lose any progress. The last tip is really, really simple too, but yet still important. Please go and call your maps something. Don't just call them Island 1, Island 2, Island 3. Go and give them an actual name to what you're doing. And if you're making duplicates like I talked about before, go and put an update badge to them. Search and Destroy 1, Search and Destroy 2, 2.2, 2.3, 3.1. Go and make different badges so you guys can keep your island list very organized. It's gonna help you in the end. Alright guys, so that's it for this video. These are my 10 tips. If you guys want to see more of this, please go and hit the like button down below. Let me know what you guys need help with and what I should be giving tips on. And yeah, besides that, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!